We've now taken a look at three examples of join statements. I now want to give you a couple notes on them, a couple of items that you might be just a little bit curious about. All right, so here we go. Here's our quick list of items that we're going to go through inside this video. So the first thing I want to mention is that the order of tables that we list out in the from clause and the join clause will usually make a difference. Let me show you what I mean. So back over here, I still have the query from when we were joining comments with photos. Take notice how we are first starting off with all the rows inside of comments, and then we are joining in the photos table. In this particular scenario, we could flip the order here. We could start off with all the rows from photos and then join in comments. If I run this, I'll get the exact same result. So in some scenarios, we can flip the order of tables here and we'll get the exact same result, but there are other scenarios where flipping the order will change the ultimate result. Now your initial question here inevitably is going to be, well, when does it make a difference? I will show you exactly when this makes a difference in the next video or two. For right now, I just want you to know that sometimes it does make a difference and sometimes it does not. Okay, let's move on to the next item. The next thing we need to understand is that if we have two column names in the join table that are the same, we have to provide a little bit of context. So, quick diagram. We are currently working with our comments table and our photos table. So we can imagine that we combine the two together into a new imaginary table called something like comments with photos. Now I want you to notice in here, we have two columns with the exact same ID. That's ID and ID. We also have user ID that are completely duplicated. Now the values inside of here are not duplicated. It's just the column names themselves. So what would happen if we ask for, say, the ID instead of contents and URL? Let's put in just ID, and if we do so, we'll end up with an error message. So it says column reference ID is ambiguous. Ambiguous means that your database doesn't know whether you are talking about this ID column or this ID column. So if you ever want to select a column that is listed twice or more inside of a join table, you have to be a little bit more explicit. You are going to designate which of those different ID columns you want by putting the name of the table that it's coming from right in front of that ID word. So in this case, we could put in photos.id. If I run that, I'll then be given the ID column from the photos table. So back here in the diagram, it would be equivalent to taking this column right here. That is the ID column that originally came from the photos table. If I want the ID column from the comments table, I would just change the word photos right there to comments instead. And now I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Now, what would happen if we put in both comments.id and photos.id? Well, unfortunately, the tool that we are using here is giving us duplicate results. That is because not the website I put together here, but a library that is being used to actually communicate with Postgres is giving some erroneous results. If you were to run this query directly against Postgres itself, you would get two different columns, but in this case, again, because of just a little library that's being used behind the scenes here, unfortunately, is getting a little bit confused on which ID column is which. So even though Postgres is okay with this query, the library that's parsing the results can't quite handle it, unfortunately. If you are ever in the same situation where you are using some library that can't figure out which ID column is which in the result set, you can always rename one of the columns. So I could rename this to as comment ID. And now the result set is more clear. So these are the IDs of all the different comments. These are the IDs of the different photos. Okay, one or two more items. In addition to renaming columns, we can also rename tables using the as keyword. And you're going to see this used fairly frequently on more complicated join statements. So for example, we could on from photos right here put in as P, just P. E being short for photos. Then everywhere else inside the query, we could replace the word photos when it is a reference to a table with just P. So for example, we could change photos right here to just P. We can also change up here in the select statement from photos.id to p.id. However, if we ever had a reference to a column that had the word photos inside of it, we cannot just replace P there. So for example, on the comments table, if this was photos ID instead of just photo ID, we could not replace photos right there with P. So it's not just a straight find and replace. It is only when we have a reference to a table. Now I can run this again, and I'll see that I still get the same result. You're going to see this shortened syntax, or the kind of abbreviation being used, especially any time that you have to embed a lot of different references to your table. One other way that you'll see this syntax shortened up is instead of using the as keyword, you can actually drop off as entirely and write out just photos p. So I can run that as well, and I still get the same result. Now, I personally do recommend that you do put in the as keyword just because it adds a little bit more clarity as to what is going on here. Anytime someone sees the word as, it's just a sign that, oh, something's going to be renamed here. All right, so that's a couple of variations on join statements. Last thing I want to mention is that there are a couple of different kinds of joins, and this is very closely related to the first item back up here. Let's take a quick pause right here, and then we're going to start to investigate the different kinds of joins that are available to us.